Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieco, and today I'm gonna be talking about sliders in 3ds Max. So, sliders. Do you know what a slider is? Like, whenever you go to any program and you have a slider, a thing that you just slide from one point to another, well, that's a slider. Cool thing is, you can actually have an actual sliders in your viewport in Max, and you can control pretty much anything with those, and they're actually super simple to set up. Now, sliders are usually used mostly in animation, but there's a lot of use case scenarios where you can use them in everyday life. So let me show you what I got here. So this is the scene where I pretty much have a teapot, torus knot, two doors, and I got a couple of lights. Now, I'm gonna turn on my sliders. Sliders are usually helper objects, so if you turn them on, boom, look at this. You got sliders, and now they're pretty much fixed on the viewport. Like, even if any viewport, like where you click, you're gonna have those there. And of course, you can hide them, unhide them, whatever you want, but let me show you how they work. So for example, I have the first slider on the bottom. It says lights, and look at this. When I increase it, it's gonna actually increase the intensity of the lights, and you can just control them through here. One thing that you can notice is I don't have any light selected, so nothing is selected, and I can directly control the intensity of these lights. Another cool thing is, if you take a look at this teapot, so the teapot is pretty much like very low poly, and I can actually control the amount of turbo smooths that this teapot has. Like, if you have, you know, like an object that's somewhere in the scene and like it's far away, you don't need a turbo smooth for it, but then you have a close-up camera, you can pretty much like have a slider for it. You don't have to click on the object, click on the turbo smooth, then increase the iteration or turn it on, turn it off, whatever. You can just use the slider for that. On the other hand, I have this torus knot here. As you can see, it has like a white, like plain white reflective material. And now if I increase my torus knot refraction, you can actually see that he's actually going to turn to be a glass torus knot. So you can even change material properties with this. On the other hand, you can even change object positions. So for example, I got these two doors and I have the door slider. So I can just open it and close it, you know, just with a slider. You can pretty much like open all the doors in the apartment, hotel, whatever you got. You just manipulate everything together. And the cool thing is, you never go and click on the object and move it or whatever. It's always there. One thing that you can notice about these doors is like when they open completely, you can notice that this one opens 180 degrees where this one opens just 90 degrees. So you can control all these things. Because for example, I would have like very, very large scene and maneuvering the scene would be very hard. You know, the things start to become laggy and then you get frustrated or whatever. You can pretty much like if you have a scene that's like a city or something and then you have lights. So even at some point, clicking at the light object and then waiting for it to load on a side and then increasing the intensities, etc. Like all that can be laggy, where with this, you don't click anything. Just move the slider, you just set up the slider, move it, and everything works. Okay, so let me show you how this whole thing with the sliders work. So go to the create panel, go here to the right where it says helpers, click on that, and here you have a slider. Click on the slider and just click anywhere on your viewport, and that's where the slider is gonna be. If you keep clicking, you're just gonna add multiple sliders everywhere. Now, if you go to the modify panel, here you pretty much set up the slider. You set up just some basic functionalities. So label, you know what? Let's create a slider that's gonna increase the light intensity. I think it's a good example. So on the label, I'm just gonna type light intensity. Okay, as you can see, the name shows up here. Now, if you want to move this slider all the way to the left or right, you cannot just click it. As you can see, nothing will happen. And that's because to control a slider, you need to have the select and manipulate button turned on. This one. Yeah, that's what that button does. Anyhow, when you click that button, just click on the left square here, and now you can move the slider wherever you want. Additionally, if you, for example, push this one to the right, you're just gonna, like, you can create a very, very big slider. Then here you just have the slider, which you can now manipulate, because if this is turned off, you can't do anything with it. So turn on, select, and manipulate. Okay, now the little plus that you see here, if you click that, it's just gonna remove the slider. So it can just keep your scene to look kind of tidy. And of course, with the plus, you just retrieve it back. Now, let me show you what a couple of these options do, like how does this thing work. So value is pretty much your slider. Let me just move this here. So as you can see, like when you increase or decrease the value, you're pretty much moving the slider. Minimum and maximum, this is how much the slider can go. So When I move the slider all the way to the left, you see it says 0.0, that's the minimum value. Now, if you go all the way to the right, it will say 100, and this is this 100 here. So just change that to, I don't know, 500. And now you can move your slider all the way to the 500. You can even make the slider smaller, it will not affect those values. Now, let me show you how you can link this thing. So I'm gonna be linking this to our light intensity of our lights here. So I got 6 lights here, and those lights are all instances. So this is what you do. So we're actually gonna use wire parameters here. With wire parameters in max, you can pretty much tell, you know, feature A can control feature B, and this is pretty much what we're gonna do. I'm gonna tell with wire parameters that the intensity of the light will be controlled by the slider. That's it. It's actually that simple also. So look at this. Right click on the light, go here where it says wire parameters, click that. Now you're gonna get these two options. Transform is whether you wanna do something with the movement of the light, rotation, scale, etc., or you just wanna mess with the options of the light, the bottom option. This is the one that you want. So click here, just find intensity, click on it, and now you're gonna get this dotted line. And now with this dotted line, you just need to specify what will that intensity do. So let's link that to our slider. So when you click on the slider, just go on the bottom where it says object slider. Here you're going to see the options of the slider. Remember, value was the actual slider that you move left and right. So just click the value button, and now this monstrosity will pop up. Here you have two buttons to click. This one, and click connect. That's it. By the way, what does this button do? So look at this, like when I scroll down, it pretty much says that this value from the slider, you see the slider here, corona light is here, slider is there. So it pretty much says that the value is gonna affect the intensity and vice versa. If I clicked this button, what would that do? My slider would affect the intensity, but not the other way around. But you can experiment that on your own. Let's just continue with this. So click the upper button and just click update or whatever. Now, close this, and now look at this. I have my scene. If I just move the light intensity here, it's gonna be linked. See this? Like, you can control it easily like that. You can even see the intensity here changing. Cool thing is, if I go here and just increase my intensity up and down, it's actually gonna mess with the slider. So yeah, you can just have your intensity here. Now, let me show you how I did the whole turbo smooth thing. And it's pretty much as easy as the other thing. Okay, let's continue. So I wanna add the turbo smooth iterations to a slider. So how do you go about that? So first, of course, you need to have turbo smooth on your object. And now just go to the slider, click the slider, place it here, name that slider, let's call this teapot turbo smooth. Now, minimum maximum value. Number one here is one iteration. So if you keep this from 0 to 100, you're gonna add 100 iterations of turbo smooth, and you do not want that. So let's add this to be, I don't know, 4 iterations. So minimum 0, maximum 4. Now, click on your teapot, right click, wire parameters, go to the modified object, and here you're gonna have turbo smooth, and here you're gonna have iterations. Click on that and just link those iterations to your teapot turbo smooth slider. So click here and just say, I wanna control the value. This window opens up, click this and just click connect. So now let me just increase the slider. Now when I move it from left to right, you can actually see how iterations are growing, and that's pretty much how it works. And this is practically how this works. Like if you want to control something in the material, for example, this torus knot has a white reflective material, just go to wire parameters, and here, as you can see, you have object torus knot. You can control all the things that he offers, and then you just go to the material, and here you can pretty much pick which option from the material you want to control. In my previous example, I actually had this level of refract, and that's how I increased the refraction with the slider without even touching the material editor. Now let me just show you how I did the whole thing with the doors. So for the doors to work, of course, the pivot of the doors needs to be correctly placed so that you can normally open doors, right? Now, select the slider, let's put it here. I'm gonna call the slider, let's say doors, and this is how we go about it. Select the door, right click, wire parameters. Now you wanna mess with the transform. because you want to move it or rotate it or scale it. So go to the transform, go to the rotation and choose Z rotation. When you click that, now you want to do something with that Z rotation. So you just click it on the doors. Now here, of course, you want to affect the value. So click that, connect in both directions and click connect. And now if you just move the slider, you can see that the doors are pretty much endlessly and fractally rotating. So how do you generally control like how to open the doors? I'm just going to show you a very primitive way on how to do that. So select your slider. By the way, when select and manipulate is on, you need to double click on the slider to show its properties. But yeah, anyhow, just go to the value section here and just see how much, like how much open the door you want. So for me, I want my door to open, let's say, I don't know, this much. So that's value 3. So what do you do here? Just place minimum value to be 0 and then maximum value to be 3. And now if you want to open the door, this is how it's going to look like. Now, how do you make these doors to open up only 90 degrees? It's a little bit more complicated, but bear with me. So right click, go to wire parameters, transform, rotation, Z rotation. You want to link it to the doors again. Now here, just click on the value. Here on the right, you have your slider. Here on the left, you have our door, which is called box, because why would it be called a door? And what do you want to do? You want to make the value, so the slider, right? You want to make the value 2 times weaker, because if I'm opening the door 180 degrees, you want to open it just 90 degrees. You can like divide this value by 2 or multiply it by 0.5. It's going to do the same thing. Here, you can pretty much put all the mathematical equations for things to work. So look, if I put divide by 2, click the two-way connection and click connect, look what happens. You click on the door and it just opens to the 90 degrees. As you can see here, look, the left one opens completely, the right one opens only halfway. And that's pretty much how you do it. Look, now you can just, you know, animate all the doors. But there is one problem with wire parameters. Wire parameters is all cool because you can link everything to it. But what if you have like 300 doors? Well, in that case, wire parameter can wire one object at a time, meaning that you could wire all 300 doors, but you would need to go one by one, every single door, wire it, etc. But to make this process easier, Max has this feature which is called a reaction manager. With reaction manager, you can do much more complex riggings. So I was actually thinking, like, should I cover the reaction manager tutorial? But my dear friend Johannes Lindquist from Texture Supply, he actually made an amazing tutorial about reaction manager and how it works. So I generally encourage you to check that one out, because it's not long, it's like 3.5 minutes. It's super informative. It's called Slider Controllers Using Reaction Manager in 3ds Max. And yeah, with Reaction Manager, you can like have things like being animated, etc. Wire parameters is just, you know, straight linear, go from point A to point B. That's what it does. But yeah, this is this little tutorial where I just wanted to show you like the wonders that you can do with the sliders. You can pretty much create like your own interface where you can just easily reach a lot of things and just manipulate whatever you want. But before you go and check out Johannes's tutorial, I want you to make one quick pit stop, and that's on the Evermotion website, because their ArcMolus 292 is now up to 25% off. So here you can generally get all these awesome props. Look at this, all of these things, you can get that, and I think that your bathroomy needs might be completely satisfied with this. Or if you do not wish to check out the shop, you can always go to the news section and look, tons of articles, things that you can watch, videos, all the industry news, it's all here. Check out the Evermotion website, and as usual, thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Bye.